In this learning module, we will take a high-level look at the TERR statistical engine from the perspective of how it can be leveraged from within the TIBCO Spotfire desktop client in order to extend your computational or data handling capabilities. TERR stands for TIBCO Enterprise Runtime for R, and although it is a product which can be implemented in other locations across the TIBCO Analytics platform, our focus will be on the locally installed instance of TERR, which is provided as a part of the Spotfire desktop installation. Let's begin with an introduction to TERR. First off, you need to understand that R is a statistical programming language which is broadly applied by data analysts and data scientists toward a wide variety of industry and academic endpoints. However, because this open source tool has its roots in academia and was not intended for high performance production applications, TIBCO designed an enterprise grade statistical engine to be fully compatible with the R language, which provides a high performance solution with more robust memory management than open source R. As indicated, TERR is embedded in the TIBCO Spotfire desktop client as a local statistical engine. So the good news is, you don't have to do anything to configure the use of this statistical engine. It's ready to go by default. However, you should be aware that the TERR statistical engine is separate from the data engine which is responsible for other calculations and data handling performed by the desktop client. Now that you know what TERR is and where TERR exists, how do you enter the scripts or instructions for computational execution on the TERR engine? Well, there are two options for entering TERR scripts. It may be configured within the Spotfire expression language, or it may be configured as a data function. Just to make things a little bit easier, let's take the data function option off the table for now. Don't worry, we will return to discuss that option in just a few minutes. But first, with our focus solely upon the option to implement TERR scripts within the Spotfire expression language, there are two ways to enter TERR script. You can use one of the TERR functions which are available in the various expressions dialogs. Once you have inserted the function which represents the data type for the expected output from your script, the function can be edited to supply the necessary input variables and arguments. The other option is to create an expression function in a separate dialog, where you can enter all of the script instructions, as well as a detailed description for your new custom function. Your custom function then becomes a new function option within the various expressions dialogs. After inserting your custom expression function, all you have to do is insert the arguments for the necessary input variables. This makes expression functions a good option for more complex scripts or scripts which you wish to reuse throughout an analysis document. It is important to note that with either option A or B, even though the instructional script or expression function is included as part of a Spotfire expression, the script is not executed using the Spotfire client's data engine, as are the in-memory data analysis functions discussed in the previous section of this course. Instead, these scripts are run on the TERR statistical engine. It is interesting to note that these options for entering a TERR script may be combined with the Spotfire expression constructs we learned in the previous section of this course, such that both engines are required in the process of executing the expression. Consequently, you may leverage both the capabilities of the Spotfire expression language and the R statistical language in order to achieve your desired analytical endpoints. As mentioned previously, an alternative to entering TERR script in expressions is to create a data function. Creating data functions is a two-step process. First, you register the data function, which involves entering the script and defining the input and output variables described within that script. Once you have the data function of interest defined, it's time to run the data function. The first time you run the data function, you will have to assign the input and output values associated with your current analysis document. For example, which columns or property values will serve as input, and should the output be returned as a new column, a new data table, or a new property value. Once these parameters are mapped, these definitions become part of the analysis document, which can be edited under the Data Function Properties dialog. And of course, running the data function also causes the instructional script to be processed on the TERR statistical engine. Let's take a quick look at an example where a data function has been configured to calculate a rolling correlation. Use Open File and navigate to the file with Data Function Example in the title. click Open, and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This example is designed to work with these two stock market indices and calculate a rolling correlation using the TERR statistical engine. So you can consider the Dow Jones and NASDAQ columns to be two of our input variables. In addition, two property controls have been configured in order to collect additional required input variables, the rolling correlation window and the correlation method, which is to be applied. These four input variables are supplied to the rolling correlation R script, and the output results in this column of correlation values, which are displayed here, plotted over time. If we change either of the property values using these controls, the resulting correlation column, which results from the execution of the R script on the TERR statistical engine, is updated. The script, which is responsible for this calculation, can be viewed by going to Edit, Data Function Properties, and from the resulting dialog, you can select the rolling correlation data function and click the Edit Script button. Although we won't go into any detail regarding the interpretation of this script in this learning module, you can see the input variables and the output variable, which allow for interaction between the data in Spotfire and the TERR statistical engine.